lead us into a kingdom of peace for our God. Alleluia. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, author of our freedom and of our salvation, listen to the voice of our pleading, and grant that those you have redeemed with the shedding of your Son's blood may have life through you, and under your protection rejoice forever unharmed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul stood up in the synagogue at Antioch in Pisidia, held up a hand for silence, and began to speak. My brothers, sons of Abraham's race, and all you who fear God, this message of salvation is meant for you. What the people of Jerusalem and their rulers did, though they did not realize it, was in fact to fulfill the prophecies read on every Sabbath. Though they found nothing to justify his death, they condemned him and asked Pilate to have him executed. When they had carried out everything the scripture foretells about him, they took him down from the tree and buried him in a tomb. But God raised him from the dead, and for many days he appeared to those who had accompanied him from Galilee to Jerusalem. And it is these same companions of his that are now his witnesses before our people. We have come here to tell you the good news. It was to our ancestors that God made the promise, but it is to us, their children, that he has fulfilled it by raising Jesus from the dead. As scripture says in the first Psalm, you are my son, today I have become your father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Response to the Psalm is, Alleluia.
Alleluia.
It is I who have set up my king on Zion, my holy mountain. I will announce the decree of the Lord. The Lord said to me, you are my son, it is I who have begotten you this day.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Ask and I shall bequeath you the nations, put the ends of the earth in your possession. With a rod of iron you will break them, shatter them like a potter's jar.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Now, O kings, understand, take warning, rulers of the earth. Serve the Lord with awe and trembling. Pay him your homage.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Please stand to greet the gospel.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
I am the way, the truth, and the life, says the Lord. No one can come to the Father except through me.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If so or not, I should have told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you. and after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said, Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus, you are indeed the way, the truth, and the life. In the assurance of our faith, we now turn to you in prayer. Be the support of those who suffer for their faith in you. Strengthen and console them by your Holy Spirit. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Lighten the burden of those weighed down with personal cares, problems and sufferings in this time of pandemic. May they come to know how close you are to the brokenhearted. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Help us to nurture in our heart the life you have implanted in us through baptism. Make us living members of your body. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And we pray for all our own intentions. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And we pray for all who have died. We remember Margaret Hamill, whose first anniversary is today, and the anniversaries of Charles and Tommaso Fee, John Duffy, Robert Hamill, John McCann, Mary McCann, Joan Farnham, and Anthony McGuigan. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed,
to the mercy
of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let us pray. Father in heaven, you are the source of life, and you have sent your Son into the world that we may have that life in abundance. Help us so to live that we may come to the fullness of that life in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, and with the comfort of the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
And may the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the good of all his holy church.
Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, of your family, that under your protective care they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just our duty and our salvation, at all times to extend you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all is with him. Therefore, overcome the past of joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers of the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Glory.
O Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, my Lord and my God. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring us the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Leon, our Bishop, his assistant Bishop Michael, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, our venerable spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us,
and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who will live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof.
But only say the word.
Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was known, that anyone who fled your protection, implored your help, or sought your intercession, inspired with this confidence, I fly unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To you I come, before you I mean, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in your mercy hear and amen. Let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Stay.